Hi, how are you?
Hello.
Hi, everyone. How are you?
Hello.
Good.
Who's leading this team?
My name's Heather, and I'm usually with the socialization group. I know we have Hallie here, and she's usually with the housing group. So I guess technically either one of us, but somebody else would report out if that's what we're going to do today, if we have time for it. Did everyone enjoy the presentations?
Yes. I did have a question that I should have asked, but I'm with the housing group, but I should have asked what is the status of go-go grandparents, which I think was part of Lyft, where it wasn't as technologically hard to for older adults to access the service. It was by telephone. Does anyone know if that's still in place? It was only in northern New Jersey, I believe.
I'm sorry, Marie, what was it called again? Go-go.
Go-go grandparents.
I never heard of them.
Okay, I'm not even sure they're in existence anymore, but in terms of it was made to have seniors feel more comfortable calling someone instead of going on a computer or doing things through technology. And I don't know, I thought it was a good program, but I should have asked before.
I'm not familiar with it, so I don't know.
Okay. Maybe I should have questioned to one of the speakers. Maybe they know, or Melissa.
Yeah, maybe if you put it in the chat, they'll be able to answer your question.
Okay.
If you put it to everyone.
Okay. I just Googled it. It looks like.
Yeah, it looks.
Yeah. Rides, groceries, meals, and more.
And it looks like it's on the ADRC website for, I don't know which one this is. They have information on here with the phone number and the email, the website, and it describes it. So I would imagine yes, but I'm not sure.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know, I listened to all of the speakers and you know, I learned something new all of the time. But the one thing that, you know, there's all of these services out there, and I just don't think it's getting to the people, you know, that's the problem. I don't think many of the seniors know what's out there. And I keep thinking about that all the time. Like, you know, my father lives in, one of those, you know, places where there's a lot of elderly, they don't know about, I know they don't know about this stuff.
Right.
It all goes back to marketing and just getting information out there. And I just don't think it's out there.
Stacy, is there an on-site service coordinator where your dad lives?
I don't think so. I'm not sure.
I guess from a housing perspective, I'm in senior housing. I do other things for New Jersey Housing, but I train on-site service coordinators. And there have been many studies. We're not talking about housing, but there have been many studies that show the impact of an on-site service coordinator in a senior building. And I think, I mean, that's where all the information comes. With our senior buildings. So I think it's unfortunate that not other settings have this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I keep thinking that with this, you know, especially like hearing about the Mercer one, you know, people could get to at least daytime arts events and, you know, museums or things like that, which could help with socialization and, but again, if they don't know about it, they don't, know what to take advantage of.
Yeah.
I mean, one of the things that, I mean, it was nice to hear all those programs, and I do a lot with transportation. I sit on COST, which is the Coalition of Special Transportation. So I know a lot about the county paratransits. I know a lot about New Jersey Transit. I know a lot about all of the different transportation groups in New Jersey, although I wasn't as familiar with the Mercer one at the last presentation. But what I still, the one problem is that there are still areas in New Jersey, you know, there's a lot of different things that are out there, but there's still areas in New Jersey that just don't have public transportation. And when you talk about getting access, if you go to Sussex County or you go down to out to Warren County or some of these counties that are more rural, there's just not a lot out there. One of the biggest issues is a lot of these senior communities that are being built are not built on a where there's public transportation. And they promise that they'll offer transportation to their, you know, to the people that move out there, but that lasts about a year. And then they realize how expensive it is, and then they can't get the drivers and stuff. So then they punt. And then people are left without transportation. Or people move into these facilities when they can drive. And as they age in these facilities, then they realize they can't drive anymore, and suddenly they have no way to get anywhere. So it's the problem is, I think there's got to be more coordination. And they say like Uber and Lyft are great because they do provide a lot of more flexibility in areas where there's not as much transportation. But once again, if there's not many people living up in Sussex County, they may not have access to Uber and Lyft as well. But for people on fixed incomes, that can get very expensive very fast. So, you know, things like Access Link is great, but you have to be on a local, you have to be on a bus route or within 3/4 of a mile of a bus route. For county paratransits, they are great as long as you stay within the county and you can work within their hours, because they may not offer hours late in the evening. You know, they only offer from like 9 to 5 or 7 to 5 in the day. So there are a lot of, as great as our public transportation system is compared to other states, it still leaves a lot of people who won't have access to transportation. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what the answer to that is, because there's just not a lot of funding for it. And right now they're having problems with drivers, getting drivers. It's been a real problem getting drivers. So even where the county paratransit has cut back on services because they just don't have drivers. So.
So I am hearing that there are many constraints to transportation in terms of location and all the other barriers that speakers brought up during the earlier session. And you're right. I mean, I think it's a difficult issue to resolve, and it takes money.
It takes money. And I think, as I say, a lot of times it takes planning. It bugs me to no end that all these new 55 and older communities are being built in areas where they just have no public transportation. Because, as they say, the problem is when people move into those facilities or those areas, they're 55, they're 60, they're young, they're not having problems with transportation. But if they continue to live there till they're 80 and 85, they may not be able to drive after that point.
I'm sorry. I think, no, Mary, though, no. From a housing perspective and from an affordable housing perspective, there's a little difference. I mean, the age 55 and older communities, I think those individuals have higher incomes in terms of affordable housing. And what we do at New Jersey Housing and what we do through HUD is that, so for instance, we fund tax credit building, senior and family. And part of the application process is very competitive, but we look at, or we ask the developers to talk about what services are in the area, including transportation. How close are you to transportation? How close are you in terms of age friendliness? How close are you to the community? How is it walkable? Is your prospective building walkable? And I think that that's one of the differences in terms of the age 55 communities and more affordable housing options.
Yeah, I'm tending to think of the ones, I know this is a big problem down in like Ocean County, because Ocean County has a very large paratransit system, but Ocean County is where they're building all of those 55 yes. and older communities
yes.
because they have a lot of land. I mean, I understand why, because it's open space, you know, they have a lot of open space to build these communities, but it is becoming a problem because mm-hmm. they say where they're being built, there is no public transportation.
Yes.
So then people are totally reliant on the county paratransit system or Uber and Lyft or things like that. But I think it is important that people know what services are available. And I think, and I don't think people do. I mean, I will agree. I think there is a lot there. And I don't think necessarily all people know, especially people who may be aging and who have driven all their lives and suddenly they no longer can drive. And they don't necessarily know what's available. I mean, I know about this. You know, I'm sitting here, I'm dealing with an aunt who's 91 years old, who just, you know, we had to take away her keys because she just got in a car accident and she is not able to drive anymore. And she doesn't have any idea about what to do and how to go about getting transportation because yeah. she's never had to do it. And she's got dementia. So it's really hard for her in general. So, and I think that's going to be, I think that's a lot of people, because I say by the time they get to that point where they need public transportation, and they lose their ability, the independence to be able to drive, they're not fully familiar with what's out there. And how do we get that information to them or to their family members so that they can help them navigate the system?
And that's a really good point, because families don't necessarily live near their parents or their grandparents or their aunts. So that's a very good point in terms of constraints and the need to communicate or to market not only to the senior or the disabled individual, but also where are their families and how can we communicate with them in terms of transportation options.
So did anybody learn anything about things that they weren't as familiar with? As I say, for me, it was the Mercer County program that I was not familiar with. I mean, I know about TRADE, which is the county paratransit, but I wasn't aware of this other program. So that was to me.
Yeah, me also. I wrote that all the information down on that one because I'd like to share that with some people. I do live in Mercer County and I have not heard of that. I also, in my spare time, I have a nonprofit and I work very closely with Robert Wood Johnson in Hamilton. And I remember meeting with one of the social service people and they were telling me how hard it is for the patients to find rides for chemo. And they brought that up on the call. I know this is 65 and older, but I wanted to talk to them about this again because they were talking about the issue with rides. So yeah, that was interesting.
I do think one of the programs that they mentioned New Jersey Transit was talking about, and I worked with them a lot, is New Jersey TIP, Travel Independence. That is a really good program. And I know they're really trying to expand and do group trainings and stuff, because for a lot of people, they just don't know how, you know, they're scared. I mean, for me, I mean, and I'm not a senior, but I'm like, I don't want to ride the bus because I don't know when I'm supposed to put the money in the thing. And I don't know how to tell them I want to get off at a certain stop. And there's like things like that, that you're just scared of because you've never done it before. And you don't want to look like a fool and you don't want to miss your stop. And you don't want to wind up being on the bus going around and around and around because you don't know how to get off, things like that. And it's very frightening for people. And I think, you know, having the knowledge of going on a bus, you know, having someone train you that this is how you go about getting on a bus, this is how you pay, this is how you let the bus driver know you want to get off at this particular stop, this is how you, you know, this is where you need to get on the bus so that you can get on. I mean, that little bit of knowledge can go a long way to give a lot of people a lot of independence. Because once you do it once and you figured it out, then it's a lot easier to do it again and to do it regularly. And like Access Link and the county paratransits, they are great, their door-to-door service, But the problem is they're shared rides. So you may not get off when you need to get off, but a regular bus has a set bus route. You know what time it's going to pick you up. You know what time it's going to drop you off. You know where you're going to be picked up, dropped off. And it the time is very set, because they say the Access Link has the 15 minutes before, 15 minutes after. You have to call ahead to make your appointment to get your ride. Whereas the bus, you just go get on the bus and get off the bus when you want to. So it's far more liberating for people if they can do the regular bus route. And it is very, but I think travel training helps people know that they can do it, because I think a lot of times people are scared. And, if they have a paratransit system, they can call up and then they can tell the bus driver, it's not as big of a group on the bus, and it's not as big of a bus. It makes people a little more comfortable, but you get a lot more freedom by the regular bus route. In terms of, you don't have to, as they say, you don't have to call ahead. You don't have to arrange your time. You don't have to schedule. You can just go get the bus when the bus comes and get off the bus when the bus comes. So I think the travel training is really important. And I think it's especially important for seniors, because they say, if you've never ridden public transportation and then to suddenly have to do it, or to, it's kind of intimidating and kind of frightening. Okay, now I'm going to stop talking, because I've been talking a lot. Someone else can talk.
Listen, I'm scared to get on a train, so I'm not a big public transportation person. I get it. When I get older, I'm going to have problems.
I'll take you wherever you want, Stacey.
I can bring it.
Even though I'm older than you.
Guess there's really not much more for us to talk about.
I'm wondering, I'm really intrigued with Go-Go Grandparents. I don't think it became a big hit throughout New Jersey, and I'd like to see that replicated. Wow, I have such big ideas. Like, that's easy to say. But I'm wondering, well, we'll go back to the larger session, and I'll put the question in the chat then. But I thought that was a really good program. The other thing I wanted to mention is that Kane University has a really great program, but it's only at Kane University, and they, through the occupational therapy department, they had a program called Let's Go or Let's Move. Don't ask me which one, but they worked with, it could be a senior housing setting, it could be a senior center setting, where they worked with seniors in terms of educating them about what it would mean, what information do you need to get from one place to another using transportation such as Lyft or Uber or paratransit, et cetera. And they did have this wonderful program, but at this point it's not replicated because of financial constraints, which is a shame. But I thought that was a really good program as well. And it was very successful.
Marie, I'm looking at Go-Go Grandparents, and I'm looking at complaints, actually.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, okay. I mean, there seems to be a lot here.
A lot of complaints? Okay.
Yeah.
Well, let's not replicate it then.
I mean, seems like a good concept. I'm just reading.
Yeah, it does seem like a good concept. I think it's less frightening than having to go on a computer and kind of know how to access the information from Lyft or Lyft, and it's on your phone, right? So I'm not, there's also the issue with the digital divide with lower income seniors. Mm-hmm. I mean, in terms of technology, we found that out during COVID and trying to get your vaccination and make an appointment. So I think that's an issue in terms of Uber and Lyft. To do it through your phone, I think that can be daunting for seniors.
I agree.
And for myself, by the way.
I base everything off of my father and the few people that I know that he's right. with, and they have a lot of problems with cell phones, computers.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Well, I'm not sure. I think they said there wouldn't be that much time to do kind of a summary of each group, that we might do it in December.
Yes. I thought that's.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are they bringing us back?
No, I just thought I'd mention it.
I know. I know.
Because I'm very shy. We have
9 minutes left.
So Heather and Mary Eileen, where are you from? What organizations?
I'm from the New Jersey State Council on the Arts.
Okay, right. You said that, yes. And
I'm with the Division of Aging Services.
Okay, so great, wonderful. And Stacy's with DCA.
And I'm with Disability Rights New Jersey.
What department do you work with, Heather? What section?
Sorry, my mouse keeps getting lost. I work for the state of New Jersey.
Right, but which set, like CHISP or, you know, which section?
It's Department of Human Services.
No, that's not, there's specific programs. Are you related to it?
I'm overall, like overall the Division of Aging Services.
Okay, great.
All the programs that we offer here.
Okay, great.
I've been with DCA so long that many, many years ago, the Division on Aging was actually in this department.
Yes.
Now I just aged myself.
I remember that.
Division on Women, Division on Aging. We had it all.
What were your thoughts on the socialization portion of the transportation? You think that a lot of people, even though like people were dropping things off, they're probably not talking as long, right, to the person who's dropping off their supplies, if they're even talking to them at all. Mm-hmm. A lot of times they just drop it at the door and leave.
It was something I didn't even think about at all.
That was the same for me also. I didn't think about it till they said it. That they probably get on the bus or, you know, in the car and chat for their ride. And a lot of them probably look forward to that.
Yeah, I think so too. Are all of you working from home today?
No.
No.
Are you?
No, I'm in the office and it's about 110 degrees here. It is so hot, I'm melting. I can't stand it. It's been hot all day. It's horrible.
They turned on the heat and didn't take into account the temperature outside.
Oh my God, it's terrible in here.
We can't open the windows in our building.
No, I know we can't either. They feel that people will jump. So have you heard on how they're going to put this paper together, this white paper? At the end of these meetings.
Oh, the blueprint, you mean?
Yeah, like a white paper, yeah.
I'm not sure. We have to have some meetings to bring in seniors to hear their voices so that their voices can be heard. And after that, I guess that we're gonna really start meeting together and coming up with some bullet points of what's gonna actually go into the blueprint. That's my understanding. And from our chat, it seems like there, even though there are services out there, that it's a lot of people aren't aware of them.
Right.
Is that the biggest takeaway that we've gotten from this group?
From me, yes. I don't, yeah. I'm wondering, the county agencies on aging, what do they send? Shouldn't they be the ones sending everything out to these over 55 places? You know, just as a normal course of business. You know what I mean?
I'm not sure if that's something that they do. That'd be a good question, though. We should ask that when we report out. Because I'm sure they have a list of who they're serving in their community, right?
I would think so. Mm-hmm.
They know where the senior buildings are.
Many years ago, I was working on a committee for the county, and we were putting together a welcome to the neighborhood booklet. Not that it ever went anywhere, but I remember putting a lot of work into it. And I could see something like that, you know, for the over 55s. Welcome to the, and this is out there for you. I think it would be really helpful.
And that sounds like something that Maria was talking about earlier, right? About they have them on site. On-site services coordinators?
On-site services coordinator.
That sounds like something that they would do as well.
Yes.
But the question is, where do they get their information from?
Right.
Or if there isn't a service coordinator, who do you go to do the marketing or the notifications? Well, we have 7 more minutes to go. Or 5.
1 more minute. Is someone able to report out on our findings from our group discussion?
Go ahead, Maria, you do it. Now you can ask about go grandparents.
Yeah, that's my big contribution. Well, does anyone want to do it really? I'm okay not doing it. I know I'm very talkative, but I'm okay not doing it. No takers?
Maria, I think we volunteered you.
No, don't. If forced to, I will. But you can back me up, everyone.
Of course. Just have to open my office door, excuse me. It's just sweltering in here.